you want to, like, you are moving, but I want to have real contact, like feeling. Yeah.
And?
Yeah. You? Just looking. So I see how many more you can do that. But you decide where you want to go, playing the head a little bit, and if he starts going fast and you didn't want to, bring him back to the water. Don't be hesitant to bring him back. You know, so breathe in and out, keep your hip relaxed, but you know, correcting the path off if you have to. Yeah, just do a few turns with him first.
Okay.
Just have a feel and see how light you can make it, how little you can make the commands. And do remember that you need to do turns, you want to lift your inside hand. But slow him down a little bit. So, yeah. Okay. See if you keep him in warm. Sort of like 5 meter circle, really small ones. Inside hand up. And see if you can bend him when you do that. Slow him down. Good. Slow him down even more. Yeah. So think of when you want to write a 5 meter circle that you want to have him bend to 5 meter circle. So that means you need to see. You need to see his eye. You want to have, on a 5 meter circle, I would want to see probably that much bend.
Okay.
Yeah? What did you see that? Yeah, I don't know. Right? So, have that bend. So to get that bend, lift that inside hand. So if you find that if I have to do it this high, I do it this high.
Always think.
Your nipple height's pretty good. I generally carry them about belly button high. I carry them fairly high anyway. Because it gives me a nice loose sort of set of shoulders and stuff. So if I need to lift from there, it's not that much lift. But obviously once I've figured out and he's figured out what I want, the lift will become smaller. But while you're trying to get it in your mind, you want to lift higher just to get the movement into your head. Yeah?
Yeah.
So there's probably no point just lifting it, because if you want to bend, you also have to shorten it. So as a precursor, I'm going to run my hand down a fraction, then lift it.
Okay.
Then you get the bend. But correspondingly, obviously, you have to make sure that he can bend on the upside.
Yeah?
So it tends to be shorten on the inside lift and just bring the outside hand maybe forward a fraction. Think also very strongly you want to turn your shoulders to where you want to go. So if you're riding a 5 meter circle, you want to go. A 5 meter circle would be, say, from here to that close. If I want to ride over there, where should my shoulders be pointing? Which will actually, it's not just the shoulders, it's your hips too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah? And then you're automatically kind of setting everything up. So if you combine that with run your hand down here at the rein, you're setting them up to go really, really, really very easily. And your bending will be correct.
Mm.
Yeah? So it's really, really, really super important that you do that. Focus to where you're going to go, because it means your nose, your sternum, your belly button will point that way. And that will turn your shoulder over to the rein. And with that then, the outside shoulder is automatically kind of going forward, giving that little hip so that you lengthen that outside rein. But the inside rein determines the bend.
Mm.
Is that information overload?
No, it's okay. It correlates with one.
Sidewise stuff until you can get bend in the horse. If you don't get bend in the horse, you're going to get some kind of leggy crack. And if you really want to have a success feel of it, do it on the left hand side. This is much better on the left hand side. So when you first ask it, do it there. But first, I want to see a couple of good small circles.
Okay.
So think of Volta. So you can kind of go up here, do a Volta, and then return. Whereas if this is straight, it's just going to do that around the circle. So, and once you can kind of feel that, what you can do is you're running a 5 meter circle, you feel this bit. Then you can shift your weight in and out, and you'll see that you'll make the circle bigger.
Oh, you're shifting your weight out. You make the circle smaller.
And then you, of course, can get more tricky and start doing shoulders in, like quads in, all that stuff. But if we can just do a few really nice circles with bend. The bend you get with the, yeah?
Yeah.
And then once we've seen that, we'll see what's going on. If you have to put a tiny bit of weight on, you can put a bit on. It's probably just going to slip. Which means even maybe it's going to slip. So do that as a precursor to turning or to bending in.
Okay.
So you just actually shorten it by whatever, start that. And then lift it. And I want to see, you're still kind of going, I'm lifting. So that's my starting position. For you to learn this now, so shorten it. And then lift it. Lift it. Yeah, just to let that sink in the soul. Exaggerate. Don't think about how stupid it is. I don't write when I'm doing that. Oh. But at the beginning, to make myself focus on it, I used to go, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Okay.
Yeah? Yep. And then experiment with your weight.
good band.
Yeah, you just what happens is if you kind of loop and bend it, if you bend it, you might just automatically give yourself a little bit of release. But at that point I'm trying to float you. I don't hold it that hard for a while I want it to be bent.
Yeah.
Yeah? So I kind of it's like constantly talking to it. And constantly sort of it's not a break cable. It's a telephone.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So you're constantly talking to him. So if you ask him to bend and he's given to you, then you're obviously gonna say to him, yeah, that's what I want, it's not just good feedback.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because if you just say turn your head and you turn your head and hold it there, he's like
where's the release?
Because to him that's just an enforcement at that point in time, it's not a request and a reward for doing it the right way. He doesn't know if he's done the right thing or not, so eventually he's gonna do something else. Yeah? But if you ask him and he's doing it, then yeah, sure you can come soft. But that might sometimes be no more than you've got the fist around the rein, you tighten that. The release can be just relaxing your hands.
Mm.
Yeah, but you want to maintain the bend.
Yeah.
So
a bit of a...
Yeah. So just put your thumb up. So if I have the reins and I've said to you, okay, I want you to do something, and now the release can be like this on the reins. You can feel that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So yeah. Or if I find that they need to pay more attention or something, what I often do, or if I ask for something I don't quite get, or I want to sort of say, hey, something is about to happen. So you hold your hand around and say, you're in his mouth now, and I'm talking. Yeah. So if I've gone, just by lifting the rein, you can feel that, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? If I go and tighten that and loosen that, you can feel that, but you can also feel the release, yeah?
Yeah.
Just pop your hand, just pop your fingers on it. Mm-hmm. So you just go, yeah? You can also something I don't do so much anymore, but it works well for some people. If I go, so you're the mouth again, if I go, come with me, but I kind of let it... sort of almost like you're milking it. So reins, you can use them in 100,000 different ways. So use your creativity, see what works for your horse. You know, I do a lot of like work on the weight of the reins, and then if I want something, I'll open my hands and do this. That's a distinctly loud signal to people, you know?
Yeah.
That can be enough.